If you want to try Flutter without installation, or you have it installed but you want to prototype something real quick, this video is for you guys. We are going to talk about DartPad right after this intro. Hello and welcome back to channel CodeX. This is your host Afzal, and today we're going to talk about DartPad. DartPad is an online compiler where you can run console application and Flutter application based on Dart language. Even if you have Android Studio or Visual Studio Code installed, I will recommend you to watch this full video, because sometimes you just want to share a piece of code or a UI to other person, and DartPad is really going to help you out there. Well, that being said, let's fire up Google Chrome and go to dartpad.dev. I have shared a link in the description. You can go and open this website. This website will work in pretty much all the browsers. It's just a simple web application. If you are a beginner, you must be thinking what we can do with DartPad. So let me tell you that with DartPad, you can create console applications just to try out some functions, some algorithms you want to try out. And also you can create Flutter project. Just click on this sample button over here and choose any Flutter project. I'm going to choose counter application. And it will load the same template that you get in Visual Studio Code or Android Studio. So basically, this is a Flutter web application and it's going to run exactly the same on Android and iOS platform. So you can just see it real time, make any changes, click run button, and you can see the live action. Now let's discuss some of the features of DartPad that I like the most. The first feature which I'm going to talk about is documentation. Inside this source code section, you can click on any keyword. Say for example, I just want to explore what is a state and click on the documentation. It will give you the complete detail about that particular keyword. What is a state and how it's implemented, all the documentation part. Let's say what is set state, and you get whole implementation, its examples. Maybe for some of them, it's not available, like it's a small description. But at least you get something to read, right? As a beginner, this is a very good start, that when you write something, you know what are the alternatives and what are the different properties that you can use. It's really a big plus point. The second feature which I want to mention is the live preview. You can see the live preview right over here. And not only that, you can also expand and see the different behavior, how it's going to look like on a tablet device or how it's going to look like on a browser page, right? Here you get the same output side by side, and it's really very cool to me. Now the third feature which I'm going to talk about is gist. DartPad supports gist. So what that means, you can open any of your Dart-based gist file and modify it and see their output real time. Let me show you an example. I have a gist. You can go to gist.github.com and create your own gist, give it a file name, and that's it. It supports only one file, so make sure you don't create a multiple file project. So I've created a main.dart, and this is a one page or two page application. So what you can do, just copy this ID from here and open dartpad.dev and just paste that ID after that. What it will do, it will open the source code in the DartPad editor and you can see the live preview. With this means you can share your code with your client, with your tester. So you don't have to generate Android APK, iOS IPA file, upload them and make them download. So all that you can avoid. Just share this code, just share this gist to anyone and they can give the feedback, and you can make the changes and commit to the Git source here, just like you do in any normal Git source. Just refresh and it will be reflected. It's that simple. And that is the most important feature that I think about DartPad. Like, you can share this source code to anyone. And this is a working example. You can really write something like this and click on login. It will navigate you to the next page. And I have also implemented one dialog box over here. So when you click, it gives you the about dialog, right? Now, fourth feature which I'm going to talk about is online compiler, because now you're not restricted to your laptop or your computer. Anything which supports web browser, this will work over there, and you can make your changes, review them on the go. Now let's also discuss about some of the weakness of DartPad. So first thing I noticed that you cannot use third-party libraries. It's not meant for it. Like this is just to explore the platform. You cannot write a full-fledged Flutter application over here and just make a deployment, right? It's not that. This DartPad tool is meant for exploring the Flutter framework or Dart language. And the second thing which I see as a weakness is when you type in here, the IntelliSense works a little slow. So you have to keep patience while typing. It will prompt you the suggestion when you type control space, or it will give you suggestions when you press alt enter. But that takes a little bit of time. Apart from that, it works real smooth. It has all the features which you generally get in any editor. So say for example, you want to write something, press control space and it will give you suggestion. And you can see that it takes a little bit of time. And just one more thing, that it highlights all the errors real time. So whenever you make a mistake, it will tell you what happened. So apart from these two weaknesses, I don't see any challenge using DartPad.dev. I think I have summarized all of the points of DartPad. So if I have missed something, just let me know in the comment section below. And if in any means this helped you to improve your knowledge, or you learn something new in this video, make sure to hit that like button. At least I'm targeting 100 likes for this video in the first week. So let's see if we reach that point or not. And make sure to subscribe the channel and leave your feedback in the comment section below. See you guys in the next video.